Hi there and welcome to this video. In this video, I'm just going to do a quick video to show you how you can edit the sources list for Debian. And I believe this should work as well for Ubuntu and related Debian-based distros. I'm just going to start right away. And to edit the sources list, you're going to do sudo apt edit sources. Okay, so you can see mine instantly took me to edit it, and I believe I'm using Nano. However, in your case, most probably, you will find that you are asked. The next step will be you'll get a terminal request asking for which editor you should use, and you can choose Nano or Vim or whichever one you have installed on your system. So you'll just press either 1, 2, and it will open, and it will open the editor with the sources list. In my case, you can see this is the Bookworm sources list, and you can change it and you can paste your sources in here. Especially when you install a new Debian distro, usually you'll need to add the sources in here. And I'm going to add this as a sample in the description if you need to have these sources as well on your sources list. If you want to save, of course, you can do in Nano, you're going to do Control X and then Control X and then Y to accept the changes. But if you're using Vim, you can do Shift ZZ or you can do colon WQ, and that's going to exit out of Vim. WQ exclamation mark, and that's going to exit you out of Vim. But if you're on a desktop, make sure you install Vim. Just do sudo apt install Vim, and then that will allow you to use commands like Shift ZZ to save or Shift ZQ to close it without saving. So in this case, I'm using Nano. I'm just going to do Control X. And since I didn't change anything, it's just going to close it. So that's it. It's just that one line. Sudo apt edit sources is going to allow you to edit the default sources. For the other sources files, and usually you'll find that when you install other applications, they will bring their own source files. And the source files can be found under, you can just do ls. Let's just search for it. ls, and you'll find it under etc. You'll find it inside of apt. And then since I don't know where to go next, I'm just going to press tab twice, and that's going to list the files which are there for me. And I can see here what we have apt, and we have sources list. So we'll go into sources list. I'll press tab to autocomplete, but I want to go into the directory sources list -d. And if I press enter, it's going to show me the current source files that I have for other applications. So if you need to edit any of this, you need to remove something, it's causing errors on your system, you can just do rm to remove whichever one of these files which are here. So that's it for this video. I will see you next time in another one.